Only on Christ 17 TV, baby. Boy, oh boy, will I tell you. This shit crazy. Yeah, it's happening all the time, and that's why you need better training and stop hiring these young ass kids who's scared. You hiring scared kids to be policemen and be ready to make a life-changing decision in seconds, where they can either kill somebody or they can get killed. Either or. I'm going to say this, though. There's got to be better training all the way around the board. You shouldn't be able to patrol without you being trained like a soldier. And that's real shit. Because these young kids are getting shot for nothing. Because they scared that they grabbing something when they really not grabbing shit but a cell phone or something else or some keys or some shit like that. But check out this.
Orlando police have released body camera footage showing the moments when an officer shot and killed a 26-year-old man. Derek Diaz died last week on July 3rd. Orlando's police chief says this all started as a drug investigation, and the officer who fired the gun thought that Diaz was reaching for a gun. Now, Diaz's family is demanding answers. NBC News correspondent Stephen Romo is following this story for us. Stephen, this body cam footage, we should warn people, might be disturbing to some of our viewers. What can you tell us? What does it show?
Yeah, disturbing indeed, Kate. Diaz's family has been asking for this video ever since that shooting happened back on July 3rd. Orlando police releasing three different angles from the officers who were there, their body-worn camera footage here. We do want to listen to how this started. We do also want to note this video was blurred by the police department.
Don't move.
Well, that was Officer Jose Velez. He asked Diaz there, who was 26 years old, to hand over something that he had in his hand. It was wrapped in aluminum foil. Then, as we heard, tells him to put his hands on the steering wheel. At some point, it seems like the right hand, Diaz's right hand, goes toward the center console. And that is when Velez fires those shots and immediately backs away from that scene. And the other officers involved, their videos were released as well. That was the best angle that we see. We should note, however, there was no weapon that was actually found there at the scene.
Okay, that's important. Diaz's family and one of their attorneys I know spoke at a press conference, Stephen, earlier today. What did they say?
Yeah, as you can imagine, they were upset. They say they do have some answers now, but not enough. They want to read that police report. That has not happened yet. Here's more of what Diaz's daughter's mother had to say.
The video was so sickening to watch. I threw up while watching it. While we were watching it, we were told that they weren't going to answer any questions, that they wouldn't let us re-watch it. We got to watch the three videos one time. They said we had to leave. And that was it.
All of this is about police training.
Yes.
And we want to make sure that police are being trained to deal with citizens, especially in the downtown area where a lot of the college students are, where there's a lot of young people.
Now, we should note, Kate, police say that after he was shot, Diaz threw something out of the window. Difficult to see in the video. The family has questions about that. State agencies are now investigating.
All right, Stephen Romo following that. Thank you.
Okay, check out this. Another one, another innocent person killed. He had tinfoil. Guess what he had in there? Some drugs. Is trying to hide some drugs worth a cop shooting somebody and killing them? Absolutely fucking not. They found no weapons. If he has something inside his hand like this, right? Is that a gun? Can't you make a judgment call and say this is no gun inside this hand if he's hiding something in his hand like this? Okay, number one. Number two, he shot right away. He didn't back up, give him no time or nothing. He was scared. The cop was nervous and scared. If you were nervous and scared, motherfucker, you shouldn't have that kind of job. He was trying to hide some drugs. I don't know if it was coke, whatever the kid was trying to hide, but it's in tinfoil, and he had it in his hand. You didn't see no gun. You seen a closed hand. Can he shoot you with, is a gun gonna fit in a closed hand? Absolutely fucking not. Like the lady said, we need better training. Absolutely, because they be sending these young, scary-ass kids from the suburbs to go police cities like Orlando, Tampa, Chicago, New York, Oakland. And guess what? These young cops are terrified. They should not have a job if they scary and ready to pull the trigger on somebody for having drugs in their hand. No weapon found, no nothing. And then you only let the family watch the video once. You just killed her kid's father. She wants to see it again and see why you shot and killed the father to her child. I totally agree with that. Because they're trying to hide shit. This happens all across America. People from the police force are retiring, getting out of that business because nobody likes cops because of shit like this. So now they're bringing it down so low, you can make the force now. These kids are nervous. They're scared. They're kids from the suburbs. They've never been around people from the hood. So they automatically think something's going to happen. When the kid was just trying to hide his drugs and not go to jail, that's what it looked like, and that's what it definitely seemed like to me. And then after he shot, he tried to still throw it. Man, I'm telling you, man, they got to do better training, and they should make a higher age. I think that the same age you should be able to rent a car at 25, you should be able to be a cop. I don't think coming out the police academy, anybody under 25 should be able to be a police officer. I know that sounds wild because you could send a motherfucker to war, but check out this. They're giving way better training in the military than they're doing at the motherfucking police academy. There we go. That's the word I was looking for. You can see the guy. Once he just even moved, he shot him. My condolences goes to his family. Man, I hope you guys at least get to sue the city because that's some bullshit. They just killed somebody for nothing because he had his fist closed and he had some tinfoil, which was most likely some drugs he was trying to hide. He wasn't trying to go to jail and get his car took. That's what it looked like to me. I don't know what it looked like to you. But it looked like a scared cop shot this young man because he has something in his hand. But look, does this look like a gun? You can't even fit a gun in the palm of your hand. That right there is sickening. Young kid loses his life because a scary ass cop thinks he has a gun. They find no weapons, not even a knife, not a fucking spoon, okay? The foil is most likely some drugs he was trying to hide. He's a young kid. He's probably getting high. You're in Florida. Like they said, it's right down the block from the college. What do college kids do? They party. They turn up. They do a little fucking acid. They do fucking shroom, smoke weed, do a little coke. They get fucked up. That's what kids do. They trying to party in school. That's just what college is. Motherfuckers turn up, party, do different drugs, experiment with shit. And now this kid is dead because he had some tinfoil in his hand and you shot this young man. Now his family's grieving. They got to pay money for a funeral. And you motherfuckers have the balls not to let the lady see the footage more than one time and say that she has to leave. That's absurd. Like I said, I don't think motherfuckers should be able to be on patrol if he's under 25. If you got to be 25 years old to rent a car, you should have to be 25 years old to patrol the streets and have a gun and be able to pull motherfuckers over, and there might be a chance that you might get scared and shoot somebody by mistake, accident, or just being nervous and scared. So now the family loses a member. this guy is going to get sent home and still get paid for killing this kid, which is absolutely fucking nuts. And we got another statistic. Another dead young man. Mistaken to have a gun that absolutely had nothing but some tinfoil, which was probably some coke or some pills or something he had in some foil and was trying to hide it because he didn't want to go to jail. Who wants to go to jail? If you can hide your shit, you're going to not go to jail. You're going to do that if you're in a fucking car, if you're a young kid. It just makes absolutely no fucking sense. And I don't understand why there's not an age limit on being able to patrol. Now, you can be a cop at 21 and you can be at a desk. That's different. You ain't got to shoot nobody or do nothing. You want to be a traffic cop until you're 25 and then transfer over to patrol? That's different. But these young kids coming fresh out of school, the academy, these are young kids, scared kids from the suburbs. Never been in the hood a day in their life, most of them. And when they get around the hood, they get nervous. They get nervous and shaky. And any movement you make, they might blow your fucking head off. And that's just how the shit goes nowadays. I don't know why they keep having these young kids. And it's not always the young kids. Sometimes it's cops 28, 29, 30 years old. A motherfucker who been on the force for motherfucking 20 years. It happens. But the training of these fucking kids out the academy is nothing. The standards are so low to be a cop these days because nobody wants to do the job because everybody hates them and like nobody wants that job. You got a target on your back when you are a police officer. Because these motherfuckers are always doing some foul shit, planting shit on you, shooting you for no reason, doing stupid ass shit, being super, super aggressive. When they arrest you, they want to throw you on the ground, beat you up, punch you, do all. That's why motherfuckers don't like cops. Shit like this. I know there's some good ones somewhere. Somewhere, but most of the shit is like this. People nervous to death to move. Keep your hands on the dashboard or the steering wheel. If not, you might get your head blown off because they motherfucking is nervous. And that's, you know, that's just what I'm going to say. It's Christ 17. Condolences and prayers go out to the family. And I hope that family gets justice because that looked like some bullshit. And that cop does not need to be on the force anymore. He even needs a fucking charge. I'm not going to bullshit you. He needs a fucking charge. Because now this kid is no longer here with his family. And they got to bury him. So, with that being said, man, this is Christ 17 TV. You get pulled over. Put your hands on the steering wheel. And I don't give a fuck if they say, get your license. Don't get shit. Make them get you out the car and they can go and get your license. Because there's a good chance when you reach for whatever they ask you to reach, that gives them a reason to say you was reaching for something and give them a reason to kill you. So with that being said, everybody be safe. And like I said, put your hands on the dashboard. Don't you move because they will smoke your ass. This is Christ 17 TV. Like and subscribe. It don't cost a dime. Thank all my supporters for tuning in like always. And I'm going to be catching you on the flip side, baby, with some more stories.